Hi, Nana here. In this session, we are going to see a return on the transfer order. Ruhi has taught us about how to do it now. So we are going to experiment that, whatever she has taught. Let's go there. Let me have a change organization to 001, and then I'm going to query an item. Manage item qualities. So C01 underscore MM underscore 2 is an item which I'm going to query. So we have 60 here. I will now go there. I will now go to actions, and then I will now request a transfer order. Request a transfer order. I'm going to request it. I'm taking the same example. Requested quantity is 5. Requested date is today. Click on supply details, and then I will be having a supply details over here now. Destination sub inventory is stores. Stores is sub inventory. Source organization is C01. The Madras child. I'm leaving source sub inventory blank so that the system will be generating what? Yeah, allocation now. Click on OK. And then click on submit. For 5 quantities, I'm going to move it from the C01 child org. That is my source org. 001 is my destination, is a destination org. So click on submit now. 001 is a destination org. So yeah, supply, this thing has come now. Fine, let me take a copy of it. I will now put a notepad. So the supply or reference number is now coming over here. This is a reference number. This is called supply request reference number. Click on OK. It's not done. Now I go there, and then I will now have a look at the supply reference request number. I go to this place, click on it. I go to manage transfer orders. I can even query add field, and then I will now add the supply request reference number actually. Supply request reference number. I'm going to add it. Paste it over here, and then give a tab, and then click on search. I don't think anything else is required. Oh God, the double star is required. The source organization is C01 and then 1, the organization. Click on search, it will now come. We got this for 5 quantities now. So this is a order 146046 is a transfer order number. So I will now take away the transfer order number. I will now put it on this place. Number is 146046. Let me go to the source. If I cancel now, so let it be as such. Fine, if you click on it, it will show you all the details of this now. Right click and then duplicate. Right click and then duplicate. Let us now go to supply chain execution and then go to the inventory management. I go there, I go to the shipments now. I go to the shipments. Go to the manage shipment lines. I had to be in C011 or change the R first of all. C011R. Click on it. I've gone there. Click on manage shipment lines. And then let me paste transfer order number over here. Give a tap and then click on search. So we are searching for it. 146046 is the transfer order number. We are going to launch the pick release. So go there. It is now coming. So go to actions and then go to pick release. The pick release as well as the pick confirm will be contacted together actually, because we are not stopping the pick confirm in the organization parameter. So because of which it will be going in one go. So give a save and close. It will be going to stage. The 5 quantities will go to stage, you know, because we have sufficient quantity in the source and there will not be any problem at all. So go there. The status is not yet updated. Go there and then make a search again. You can see the shipment number also will be created. Right? It is now staged. And then if you give a save and close, you can now see the shipment number also getting created. Click on the shipment number, then perform a ship confirm. So once when you perform a ship confirm, it will be giving you a warning indicating the weight and volume. That's okay. We can ignore this and click on yes, no. Go ahead and go there. We will now right click and then duplicate and then look at the concurrents which are running now. Go to the tools, go to the scheduled process, and then have a look at the concurrents which are running. Send shipment advice will be communicating to the destination organization about when it has been shipped. If you go to the manage transfer orders, if you click on the view shipments and receipts, now you can see that the shipment is now closed and then the expected receipt date has also come because of this concurrent. The send shipment advice has not succeeded. So it has now populated the expected receipt date also on the destination or it's closed. It is not shipped. We will now go there and then we will now right click and then duplicate. Let us now receive it. You're going to receive it now. So click on the supply chain and then go to this place. Let us now perform a receipt on the destination or click on it. You go there and go to the receipts and then go to the receive expected shipments on the destination or change the org here to destination. My destination is 001 and then click on OK. Now let us now perform a receive expected shipments. I will now query on the transfer order number. My transfer order number is starting in 146. If you go there, 146, and then if you give a tap, it will be coming. Vandichi, we got it. And click on search. I'm going to query for it. Select it and then click on receive. So the moment you receive, the transfer order will be updated.
Sir, here the 001, the receiving parameters setup is not.
Yeah. 001 is a visions or everything is set actually.
Oh, okay. Correct.
Vision is fully set actually. So click on the show receipt quantity, it will now show as 5 now. So we are going to make a gate receipt. So once when you make a gate receipt, you can now see if you go and then click on what your this thing manage transfer orders, it will be received now. Right? Click on that and then you. So receive expected shipments 5 is there. Click on create receipt. So the moment you perform a receipt, it will be coming over here. So I am working on one vision org and then one of my org actually. Okay, it's not receipt. If you go to the manage transfer orders and then click on the receipt will be populated, click on done. And then click on view shipments and receipts. You can now see the receipt is being populated over here now. Now it is not delivered. Let us now go and then deliver it also. As she was saying, unless otherwise you deliver, we cannot return. That is what Ruhi is saying. So if it is just received, it will not be done. So it has to be delivered for making it eligible for a return now. So go there. So this is what, so done. And then let us now do a put away now. Click on it and then we'll now do a put away. I have forgotten to note the GRN number. So I will now put the transfer order number over here now. It is always advisable to put a GRN number and then make a put away. That is the industry practice. Click on search now. Go there. And then select it and then click on put away. You're going to perform a put away now. Click on submit by which what happens, you can now see the put away transaction was created. And if you go to the manage transfer orders and then see and click on done, the delivery also will be completed. So click on view receipt and shipments. You can now see the delivery also is completed. So the entire process of shipping is completed. Now we are going to perform a return on this now. Fine. 146046. Go there. So click on done now. And then we are already on 001R. Go there, click on it. Go to this place and then click on what? Returns. Correct returns, and then receive, and then inspect receipts, put away, correct, review.
Yeah, please.
Down, sir. Returns.
Okay, so under return, you are hit. Return receipts. Okay. It is under return receipts. Go there. So let me put the transfer order number. She is asking me to query on something else. The transfer order may not be coming. That is what she was saying now. So if you try to query, it is not coming. Click on search now. So 146, click on search. That is what Nishtha was also having a problem. Oh, we got it.
Yes.
So why upon clicking? So what Ruhi is saying is that you add a field here. That is what Ruhi is saying. Go there. So we can add a field here. What is the field here? Anybody remembering? She was asking us to add a field. Original transfer order or something like that. She was saying. I'm not able to understand the screen now. When you're performing it. We'll now go to the this thing now. So what she was saying. Or perform the transfer orders. Okay, the new transfer order will come in. Old transfer order. So manage transfer orders. Okay, such the new transfer order. Okay, it will be creating it on the second. When you initiate a return against a transfer order, the application creates a new transfer order with the transfer president transfer order. So only when you do it, what happens? It will be creating a return transfer order. So that has to be used for what? Not at this place, but on the transfer order page, you have to query on this. That is what she said. With the physical return is okay. It's okay. So if you want it, go to the manage transfer orders and there you have to query on the, add a line called original transfer order for return. So now Nishtha was having a problem here itself. Nishtha, are you there? She was saying that the transfer order number itself is not appearing. Oh God. I want to see her issue. So okay, click on search now. On the return receipts, we go there, select it and then click on return now. Might be, she may be having a problem, right click once again. Her problem, we will not try to analyze in the absence actually. We'll now go to product management. I've already asked her to do this exercise, product management, and then go to product information management. You can query the item now. Click on it. I will now browse the item. Go there. There is a C01 underscore MM underscore 2 and then make a search. C01 underscore MM underscore 2. Click on search. Go there. So I will now go to what? I am going to return it. It will not see in this place. 001, I will not see it. Click on it. I will now have a look at the specifications. I click on the specifications and I go there. I go to the sales and order management. There is one returnable column is there. Returnable is yes. Is it a reason? Because it is a master level. I'm not sure about it. Whether if Nishtha is there, we can ask her whether she has made it as yes or not. Because the sales and order management tab region is mainly for ISO actually. IRISO or IRTO actually. So
yeah, in master level it's not showing, but
we can't. Yes, means it is in the master control. It is a master control attribute, but yes, it is set to yes in master control. That is why it is now coming as yes here.
Okay.
So whether she has changed it to yes or not, I don't know. Whether because of this it's coming or not also, I don't know. Because she has to be here. So okay, let us now perform the result. I will now make a return of two quantities on this now. Two quantities I'm going to make a return on. And click on submit. Probably she must not have set the 001 to what happens that or the reverse, the transfer order parameters she must not have set actually. I think I also not set. From 001 to C01, I have not set. We'll not see what happens now. I was not set. Click on submit. So I'm also falling in the same category only. So the return transaction was created. Fine, click on it. Two quantities are getting returned now. Okay, thank you. So we will now see whether the system has created a transfer order or not. And the result is for two quantities. Fine, click on it. We'll go there. I will now go to what? Go to inventory and then go to manage transfer orders, whether the system has created a return transfer order or not. So here she is asking us to add a field, right? Original transfer order for return. That is what she is asking for. I click on it now. Original transfer order for return starts with 146 and then give it app and then click on search now. The source organization is 001. You are going to return it from this place. I click on search now. You have created a transfer order now. Yes, it's coming. So only when Nishtha comes in, what happens, we can understand about why she is not able to get it now, right? Good. So if you query on the original sales order number, it is now coming. That's what it is. Fine. Click on it.
We need other things, sir.
Yeah, we will not see whether it works or not. I'm going to click on it. So we will not try to ship the product, but I have not given the interoc parameters. We will not see whether the interoc parameters are given or not. Right click and then duplicate. We will not see the interoc parameters from 001 to C01. I'm going to click on it. We might not have given it. Go to the setup and maintenance. And then we will now have a look at it. The interoc parameters might not have been set actually. Click on it, go there, click on search, manage, inter percentage, arc percentage, para percentage, then enter now. Go there, manage interoc parameters. I will now query for location from 001 or, sorry, answer, it is 001 or to C011 or, and then click on search. Come on. Yeah, it is already set also. Oh, God. I don't know how I set it actually. So click on edit now.
No, for a direct transfer, you have set it, sir.
Ah, ha, 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 ha. Now, transfer order required is not enabled. We'll now see how the error is going to come now. The transfer order required is not there. So it is for in-transit transfer only. Transfer order is not required. So we have a transfer order available over here. So it has no shipment as a receipts, and then go to the browse items, and then go to this place where exactly it is now. Where is our transfer order? It is for 5 quantities. Where did I find out the 2 quantities now? Find that screen. Where is it? Come on. Manage transfer orders, shipments and receipts. Transfer order number is now created for 2 quantities. Yes. So I will now say it is a return transfer order. I won't take copy of it. Put it on this place now. Return TO. So return TO is also modified transfer quantity. You got it now. Awaiting fulfillment. We will not try to pick it now. Fine. We will not try to pick it. It is not an in-transit transfer. We will now see what happens to this now. The transfer order number is now awaiting fulfillment. It's okay. So when I queried, we are able to get it actually from 001 to this OR, but it is not a transfer order route now. We will now see what happens on this now. Go there. It is on this now. Right click on the duplicate. Let us now create a new one now. We will now try to go to supply chain management and then go to the inventory management and then try to pick. No, we'll now see whether it picking happens or not. Or the transfer order itself is visible or not. I have my own doubt now because it is not an in transit route. Fine, go that on it. We will now paste this shipment number 142050. 142050 and then give a tap. And then it has no query on the 001 org. So I'm going to pick it from this place and then ship it to Z01. Click on search. We'll see whether it comes or not. It's coming. Come on, yaar. I don't have any. This one is in transit, is not enabled. No. Transfer order required is not enabled from 001 to Z01. I don't know. It's all happening. When I'm purposely making a mistake, it is not making a mistake. We'll now launch the pick release and see whether it succeeds or not. Concurrent is launched. Click on OK. Save and close. We will now give it to Ruhi to horror commands actually. Now see whether it's getting staged or not. Go there. Ready to release only. Fine. Return transfer order. Order type is return transfer order is now coming in very clearly. Ready to release. I'm going to click on it. Save and close. I don't think it's creating it actually. Ah, it's staged. Come on. Go there. It's now staged. Let me go and then ship it also. It's now staged. I'm now going to ship it. These 2 quantities, I'm going to ship it now. Go there. In the meantime, what happens, you know, have the manage item quantities, how much it is showing now. Let's now open up one more tab, you can right click on the duplicate. Let us now have a look at the item quantities also.
Now where it is pointed, it would confuse. Now the meter is 001.
Yeah, 001. It was initially 60. It would have gone to 65 now. Go to the manage inventory and then have a look at it and manage item quantities. On 001, it was initially 60. If you go there, C01 underscore MM underscore 2. Now, click on search now. So it has now gone to 65. 2 is going to be returned now. Click on it. We'll now go and then perform the return actually. This is what edit shipment. We can go there. So I will now perform a ship confirmation on this now. Okay. 72196 is there. It's for 2 quantities here in the bottom. It is now showing you. Fine. Click on ship confirmation. So 2 quantities are going to move from this place to that place. Fine. Click on this now. And remember, it is not a transfer order. It is an intra transfer only. Click on save and close now. We are now returning back. So we will now have a look at the concurrent which is running now. That is concurrent. There is no concurrent at all. Right click and then duplicate. We will now have a look at the concurrent now. So once when the send shipment advice gets completed, it has to update the quantity from 65 to 63 now. So the send shipment advice has to run now. I'm now ready for running. And in this place, manage item quantities. So I go and then change the org in this place. So we'll now see the quantities of them. So instead of C011 and then enter it now. Make a search, it will show you the quantities now. So we have what in this place again C011. We will now query for C01 underscore MM underscore 2 and then give a tab. Click on search now. So it is now showing how much 9935. Now it has to go to 9937 actually, after the completion of the concurrent. So we'll wait for the concurrent to complete now. So it has to go to 9937. It is now succeeded. We'll now go there and then watch the quantity now. Click on search again. 9935. Click on search. 9937. It has to become now. I am not very sure about it whether because it is not shipped, and then we had to receive it also. Yes, we had to receive it also. So 9935 is there. So we had to receive it. Then only what happens? It will be going now. So right click and then duplicate, and then let us now receive it. Duplicate. We had to receive it in the destination or. So supply chain management, and then go to the inventory management. Let us now receive it actually. We go to zips, and then the destination or receive expected shipments on C011. Now change organization to C011. C011. Now click on OK. We will now query on the transfer order number now. We will now query on the return transfer order number. We have it over here now. We will now take a copy. 142, it starts now. 142050. Give a tap. It is coming. Come on, it is coming. Good. Come on, Nishtha. You are not there. I want to see your problem basically. Click on receive now. Right? With the in-transit shipment itself is all working now. Click on show quantity. So click on create receipt. And if you monitor this one, and whether the manage orders, manage thing, it'll all be showing over there. So it is a interrupt parameters is okay. Click on it. What is this? This we will now go to what? Go to home, and then we will now look at the transfer order. It is now received and then not yet delivered actually. Go to the supply chain execution, go to the inventory management, and then look at the transfer order number. Click on it. We'll now go to what? We'll now make it as inventory and then look at the transfer order numbers. Manage transfer orders. Any questions or anything that you just tell me. So transfer order number is 142050 is the one. And go on and make a query on this now. Select it and then go to the view shipments. It is now received but not yet delivered. Shipped is not yet received also. It is not yet received also. We'll now have a look at it. What happens now? I'm receiving. So correct is it? I had not submitted it. So click on submit now. So once when I submit it, it will be getting received now. Go there. So in this place, oh, so many screens are open now. Fine. Go there. Where is it? This is what manage interop parameters. This is shipments of the zips also. So you know, receive. And click on done and then recovery. The receive will be coming. So click on view. It will be received. And then let us now deliver it also. Go this place. And then here, receive expected shipments is not done. Let us now do a put away also. So go there, click on put away receipts. Transfer our number is 142050. Give a tab, it's coming. Fine, click on search and then let us now put away. Select and then put away. So go there and then click on search. You must enter a sub inventory here. So the question to Ruhi is what? In this place, I will now put what on RMS 1. No. I will now put a different sub inventory on this. Main, because that was already there in this place. Thank you for submitting. Fine. I am now putting it on a different subinventory. So let us now go to the manage item quantities on this now. And then have a look at it. Where is the item quantities? Manage item quantities was there. None of the screens, no? Yeah, this place is there. If you go there and make a search, it has to be 9937 actually.
It's scale.
Here on the main subinventory, it will be there. Now, my question to Ruhi is what in this place in the what is called in the managed transfer order form, we are not given what? Once again, where is that screen here? I have not closed the screen actually. I have given that as what? As a, oh, I have closed the screen. I have not kept it as a. So the transfer order required was not enabled on that screen actually. And then even then it is performing this return lecture. So that is all. And then whether the item attribute returnable has to be enabled or not, Mr. Hans answer. So there are two questions which both of them are answer. I will now go there and then show you this place. Now I will not call that setup and maintenance. I will now go to the manage transfer. Go there, click on it. Go to search now. Manage inter or parameters. We go from 001 to C011 and then click on search. So Ruhi has to answer this. Transfer order is not enabled, but even then we are able to pick confirm and then pick release and pick confirm and then ship confirm without even a transfer order.
But the return also.
On the return path, right? From 001. So maybe is it because it is only a return order that is allowing you, or what exactly it is? I'm not exactly sure. Because on a IoT in transit, we will never come to the pick and ship actually, because there is no picking involved. We will now go directly to the receiving organization and start receiving. So this is what it is working even without a transfer order. And Nishtha has to say regarding whether she has enabled the what's called the parameter of the item actually. And the item, whether she has enabled it or not. So I have closed it actually. The screen has been closed. So there are two things which are not very clear upon this now. So but it all worked for me, and that is very bad actually. Because we want some problems to come in, but the problem didn't came at all. Oh God. Okay. And thanks, Ruhi, for your information on this return transfer order. But the only thing is, without a transfer order also, it is working on the reverse route. Actually. Any other doubts? Prakash?
Good evening, sir. Good evening.
Good evening, good evening. Any doubts on this now?
Actually, I'm in Qatar.
Oh, cool.
I came here last week of June. I attended your, of course, I'm attending all your sessions. Anyway, Sunday is working day. I missed the first session last Sunday. I'll be practicing by next week.
So,
next week.
In this regard, do you have any questions? Otherwise, I will not stop the recording actually. In this transfer order return, no questions. Okay, no, let me stop it. Let me stop the recording.